Hi, Neil.
Hi, Liz.
You're the head of the corporate trading desk for our global markets division. Let's talk about stock buyback programs, which are a big issue for many of our corporate clients right now. Many companies suspended their buyback programs last year. Talk about what you saw in 2020.
Well, we understandably saw a marked decline in share repurchase activity last year. Repurchase authorizations dropped about 45% to approximately $508 billion. And that's a pace we had not seen on since 2012. We witnessed about 20% of the S&P 500 publicly terminate or suspend their share repurchase program. Again, something we have not seen since the financial crisis. And we estimate approximately an additional 20% of the S&P 500 suspended their program, but they just did not make a public announcement of that. I mean, basically what companies were trying to do was send a signal to investors that they were prioritizing balance sheet strength. Financials were particularly hard hit as the Fed prohibited them from repurchasing stock on the back of the quarterly stress test.
And how is that reflected in terms of dollars spent?
Actual dollars spent were down a more nominal 27% to approximately $600 billion, which was in line with what we saw in 2016 and 2017. So last year was a year where we actually saw a greater level of actual dollars spent than actual dollars announced in a repurchase authorization. We did see very, very high concentration where the top five repurchasers of stock accounted for 40% of total dollars repurchased, and the top 25 accounted for almost 80% of total dollars repurchased. Technology was heavily weighted in there with them representing five of the top six programs.
And what does stock buyback activity look like so far in 2021?
Well, we're off to a very robust start for this year. We see approximately $180 billion in repurchase authorizations so far. That is up about 60% year over year. A big driver of that is financials. They account for about 30%. And that's a consequence of the fact that the Fed has given the green light to the majority of the large banks to recommence their share repurchase programs. We don't believe this fervent pace of activity is sustainable throughout the balance of the year. It's our estimate that dollars spent for the S&P 500 this year should increase by about 15%, which would translate into repurchase authorizations for the entire U.S. market of about $800 billion. But that would still be, you know, top five historically.
And what's driving this activity?
Well, you know, we're seeing strong earnings growth and we're seeing very high cash balances as companies have prioritized balance sheet strength over the last three quarters. We estimate that for the S&P 500, cash and equivalents is close to historic highs of approximately $1.9 trillion. And clearly in a low interest environment, there's a very small return on that cash. So that's why we're seeing a lot of companies that are starting to return some of that cash in the form of share repurchase to shareholders. In addition to that, we estimate that approximately $200 billion of unused share repurchase dollars have been rolling into this year. So that's incremental to the $180 billion in repurchase authorizations. So certainly ample dry powder for share repurchase activity this year.
And just given the levels of market activity that we're seeing, are there concerns that companies are buying back their stocks at their peak?
It's a very good question. And, you know, in reality, high share repurchase is generally reflective of high earnings growth, which is generally reflective of high valuation and high stock price. So you have this sort of circular condition where as companies are doing well and they're generating a lot of excess cash, that's generally reflected in their stock price. And those are the companies that are in the best position to return some of that cash to investors in the form of share repurchase and dividends. In addition to that, I mean, one of the top priorities for the majority of share repurchase programs is to offset dilution from stock option exercises. And the dilution is actually more pronounced during a rising stock price environment. So companies are almost forced to be more aggressive with their share repurchase program as it's moving higher because more options are coming into the money and hence more dilution.
And how should investors be thinking about this?
Well, I think investors should look at this as a real positive. With the exception of last year, U.S. corporates have been the largest net buyers of U.S. equities for the last decade. So the reemergence of this, you know, corporate bid should continue to provide meaningful support to the broader equity markets. And equally as important, during periods of broader market dislocation, this is when companies have consistently demonstrated their willingness to aggressively step into the market. And so I think the ability for the corporate bid to provide that added layer of resilience and support is a real positive to U.S. equity investors.
Well, finally, Neil, stock buyback programs are not without controversy. President Biden has been critical of them in the past. How do you think that debate might evolve this year?
Well, 2018 was by far the most active year for share repurchase, with approximately $1.1 trillion in authorizations. This also coincided with tax reform during that year. The sheer magnitude of the number certainly caught the attention of many people, including some politicians who questioned the efficacy and adequacy of how some of those tax savings were being utilized. So the repurchase topic was actively debated in 2019. There was no new legislation enacted, but that frankly wasn't from a lack of proposals. You know, I do feel that as we continue to turn the corner on this pandemic and focus shifts elsewhere, one area will certainly be on tax reform. So I really think that, you know, there's a confluence of conditions here that I think dramatically increases the likelihood that we'll see the share repurchase topic pulled back out into the political spotlight for a debate.
Thanks, Neil.
My pleasure, Liz. Always nice catching up with you.